Hello and welcome to SciJoy. Today we're going to talk about successive approximation converters, binary math, and the significance of bits. A successive approximation converter guesses one bit of a binary number at a time. A diagram for a 3-bit encoder looks like this. The successive approximation registry makes a guess at the binary number corresponding to your voltage value. Is then sent to a digital-to-analog converter, which converts this binary value into a voltage. This voltage is then compared to the incoming analog signal that's being sampled, and the comparator tells the registry if the guess voltage is higher than or lower than the sampled voltage, and then it moves down the line to the next bit, and when all the values have been checked, the registry sends the binary number out, and the registry itself resets, and the clock regulates this entire process. And the guesses occur from the most significant bit down to the least significant bit. And to understand how each bit is weighted and the process of relating weighted bits, binary codes, voltages, and decimal numbers, we're going to need to discuss some binary math. And if you already understand the basics of binary math, you can just skip ahead to this annotated time to learn more about the weighted bits. Our decimal number system is a base 10 system, and it goes from 0 to 9. If we had the number 836, we'd say that the 8 is in the hundreds place, the 3 is in the tens place, and the 6 is in the ones place. When you're doing math in a base system, you want to raise the base to a power. So the ones place is 10 to the 0, which is equal to 1. The tens place is 10 to the 1, which is equal to 10. And the hundreds place is 10 to the 2, which is equal to 100. And so on. So 836, written in base math, is 8 times 10 raised to the 2, plus 3 times 10 raised to the 1, plus 6 times 10 raised to the 0. In other words, this would be 800 plus 30 plus 6. Binary works the same way, but instead of having numbers that range from 0 to 9, we only have 0 and 1. So let's try a 3-digit number in binary. We would have 2 raised to the 2, plus 2 raised to the 1, plus 2 raised to the 0. If the number was 101, we'd have 1 times 2 to the 2, plus 0 times 2 to the 1, plus 1 times 2 to the 0. That would be 4 plus 0 plus 1, which would give us a decimal value of 5. This shows you the math for converting binary numbers to decimal numbers for all the options for a 3-bit converter. That is the process for relating the code words to decimal numbers, and your program would output these numbers. We cannot associate a voltage value directly with a binary code word like we did with our decimal numbers, because our reference voltage could be 3.3, 5, 16, or any other number. So instead, we have to use binary fractions and a weighted system. The most significant bit is the value furthest to the left, and it's given a weight of 1 over 2 raised to the 1. And the least significant bit is given a weight of 1 over 2 raised to the n. This means the most significant bit is always going to be 1 half. And the next one will be a quarter, then an eighth, then a 16th, and so on until you reach the last digit in your code. This is what it looks like in the table. The decimal values are in the first column, the binary code words are in the second, and the voltage fraction is in the third. The voltage fraction is the decimal number divided by the number of voltage buckets. The voltage value for each of these buckets is the maximum voltage multiplied by the voltage fraction. Then we get a bit weight. This is the decimal number divided by the resolution. The last column shows you the bit significance. You can see that the bit significance corresponds to what position the 1 is in your binary code word. And here's an example for a 2-bit converter, and here's one for a 4-bit converter. And if you add the voltages from the significant bits, you'll see that they all add up to the maximum voltage. How does this relate back to our guess and check? Well, let's look at our 3-bit converter again and say we have 5 volts maximum. This tells us that our MSB will be 2.9 volts. The next one will be 1.4 and the LSB will be 0.7. The first guess made is always a 1 in the MSB position. If the sampled analog signal is greater than 2.9 volts, then the MSB stays at 1 and the 2.9 is subtracted from the sampled voltage. If it's less than that, the MSB becomes 0, and then the full incoming voltage moves down the line to the next bit. So let's look at an example. If the sample voltage is 3.7 volts, then the first bit will be a 1, and the next bit will see 0.8 volts. Since this is not greater than 1.4, the second bit is going to be set to 0. The 0.8 volts is greater than the third bit, so that's going to be set to 1. So this gives us a binary code word of 101. In the next analog to digital video, we will discuss digital logic. And for other videos on converters, you can click this playlist. You can talk to us on any of these social media platforms. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them down below. You can support us at patreon.com/scijoy. And remember, keep exploring.